Welcome back to Cooking with Catalyst. I am your host, J.R. Forresteros, and I'm here today with two of my favorite sous chefs, Stella and Clara Sweeney. Welcome, girls.
Hi.
Stella, what are we making today?
Chicken tikka masala.
That's right. We're going to talk more about the history of this dish in a minute, but first we want to go ahead and get started because we've got some chicken that we need to marinate. So I am going to finish up cutting our chicken. Stella already has done a great job cutting most of it. But we want to go ahead and cut our chicken into some bite-sized chunks. If you can, you want to, of course, keep those as close to the same size as possible so that everything cooks nice and evenly. And then once they're done, we're going to be creating a marinade that is going to go on these chickens. And you can leave these overnight if you want, because we are hungry. We're only going to be doing it for about 10 minutes. But Stella is going to go ahead and start by adding about a cup and a quarter of some plain Greek yogurt. So Stella, if you want to go ahead and add that in there. This is going to act as a binder to hold our spices to the chicken. It's going to give it that nice texture that we like once it's all fried up. And then Clara, as Stella's doing that, is going to introduce us to our spice profile. Now, when I first started cooking chicken tikka masala, it was the biggest hurdle for me was to get to the spice profile because I love Indian food, but frankly, I've never cooked it before. And so I was really unsure what the different spices did and how they contributed to the taste and all of that. So we've been just following recipes to do it. So as you can see in our little red dish here, we already have our spices measured out. But Clara, tell us what kind of spices we're going to be using in this mixture today.
So we have ground cumin, turmeric powder, garam masala, and cayenne pepper.
Now what's interesting about the garam masala is that it is a spice that is unique to Indian food, and you may not be able to find it at your grocery store. If you can't, that's okay. It's actually pretty easy to replicate at home. Just look up a good garam masala spice combination online, and it'll actually be a lot of those same spices that we've already used there. So, Claire, if you'd go ahead and add our spices to the dish. There we go. And then the last thing we're going to do is add in some garlic and ginger. So I've got minced garlic here, so I'm going to add a little over a tablespoon of that minced garlic. And then I'm going to add about a tablespoon of ginger. Now you can use minced ginger if you want. I like to just get the big tube of ginger because I find it's way easier to work with. Just a little bit more. There we go. I'm trying to learn from Sonia and measure with my heart. So now Stella's going to stir that up and get this nice and coated. And then we're going to put it in the refrigerator to marinate for about 10 minutes before we move on to the next step. One of the things we're going to need for the dish is some diced onion. So I'm going to dice that up real quick while we talk about kind of the history of this dish. So no one's exactly sure where chicken tikka masala comes from. We know that it originated in Britain in the 1960s. So that's one of the surprising facts about it, is that it's not actually from the continent of India. Most food scholars think that it originated as a take on butter chicken, which is a signature Indian dish in the northern part of India. And so a lot of scholars think that when Indian immigrants, particularly from what we now call Bangladesh, came to Britain, they decided to come up with a new way to cook their dishes, and chicken tikka masala was born. Of course, now it's a staple in most Indian food restaurants. You can find it all over the place. You know, today we're talking about curiosity, and I just think it's so interesting that so many of these foods that we enjoy in our world and in our countries and our cultures came from people who were exploring and who were innovating, right? Indian immigrants to Britain in the 1960s obviously faced a lot of discrimination and a lot of hardships. And like every other discriminated and oppressed group, they figured out ways to not only survive, but thrive. And today we quite literally enjoy the fruits of their labor when we eat foods like chicken tikka masala that we can make in the comfort of our Texas suburban home, for instance. So I think it's a really interesting testimony to the kinds of foods we eat, to the cuisines we enjoy. And I hope that as we are doing these segments, as we're learning about barbecue and Navajo tacos and chicken tikka masala and, you know, whatever future segments we do, we're constantly keeping in mind that all of these foods come from somewhere. They tell a story. And I hope that we enjoy them, but we also take time to learn about the people who produced this food and some of the story behind it. That's part of what curiosity is all about. Okay, our chicken has finished marinating, and so now we're going to go ahead and cook the chicken pieces before we start assembling the whole sauce. So Stella has the chicken pieces there. She's scooping them into our pan of oil, and then once they're finished, I'm going to be bringing them into this container just to hold them. We're going to set them aside and then add them back into the pot at the end. This is one of those big one-pot dishes, so once the chicken is finished cooking in here, we're going to actually make the sauce in this pot and then combine it all back together. And as we're doing that, Clara is going to be making our rice and also warming up our naan. Unfortunately, I am terrible at making bread, and so I did not prepare any naan from scratch. I just made it, I had Tom Thumb make it for me, so. I am taking out the last of the chicken from the pan, and so now it's time to start building our sauce. So Clara, as soon as I get these out, is gonna start by putting some butter into the pan. So Clara, if you'll go ahead and grab that butter, just toss it right down in there. There we go. And then as that melts, we're gonna add some onions. We're gonna stir these onions for about 3 minutes until they are nice and soft. And as we're doing that, then we're gonna add some more garlic and some more ginger and then let those get fragrant as we continue to build our flavor profile. And we're just gonna keep cooking this sauce because the longer we cook it, the more layers of flavor it's gonna develop and the more it's gonna give us a good complex finish, which of course is what we're aiming for. It's time to add our spices to the sauce mix. So a lot of the same spices are in here that we used before, turmeric and garam masala and cumin. But Clara, what else did we add?
The coriander.
That's right, don't tell me, tell the camera.
Coriander?
Coriander, that's right, we added coriander. So she's gonna go ahead and dump those in and then just keep stirring. And we're gonna stir for about another minute, just give a chance for all of these spices to cook together. And then we're gonna add in just a can of tomato sauce, nothing fancy here. And then we're also gonna add in a little bit of salt and some chili powder. So Claire, do you wanna grab those? Perfect.
That's pretty.
Okay, and then stir, 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 stir. And once she gets this stirred up, we're going to simmer for about 10 minutes, letting this just get, all these flavors get really combined. So we're gonna combine, drop the heat down just a little bit, and maybe make our stirring a tad less aggressive. And we'll be back when the sauce is finished.
Now it's time to finish our sauce. So here I'm going to add, very carefully, some heavy whipping cream. And I'm gonna add some brown sugar. Now it is time to add our chicken. We'll re-stir this. Stir. see is nice, turning into a nice orangey color. Now we're going to be stirring that for 10 minutes. Now we will be starting to prepare our rice.
So we have our boiling water here, and Claire is going to add in our jasmine rice. And of course we want to cover that and let it simmer for probably about 10 minutes, so it should be done right about the time our sauce is finished. And the only thing we have left to do is heat up our naan bread and chow down. Okay, it is time to plate. So we have our warm naan on the plate. Clara is going to lay down some rice as a bed. Beautiful. Okay, and then of course we are going to add our chicken tikka masala right on top of that. And as soon as it cools down, Stella is going to take a bite and tell us how it is. Of course we can't forget cilantro as a garnish, so we just want to add a little bit right to the top. All right.
Very good. It's really good. I like the taste of the rice and the sauce together. It's very good.
Mm-hmm. And cut. All right. Let's get some plates.
Oh, my.